magnified.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
For he is
worthy. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
He's worthy of all the praise.
Oh, yes, he is. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Lift him higher.
Yes, Lord.
For your God reminds us that he be lifted up. He'll draw all we need.
My Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We have your Bibles this morning. 1 Corinthians 15 chapter and 15 verse. 1 Corinthians 15 chapter and verse 15. Amen. As you find it, I ask that you stand at your feet in reverence, reading the word of God. It reads, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your toil is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. You may have your seat. Therefore, my beloved brother, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain.
Amen.
In the Lord. This morning I want to tag our text with simply keep standing.
All right.
Keep standing.
Amen.
Many of us have been through things time and time in our life that tries to knock us down.
Right. Amen.
And if we were truthful, sometimes we do get knocked down.
Right.
But I want to encourage you this morning, in spite of the things that come your way, standing.
All right.
Do you ever get discouraged?
Yes.
Do you ever feel that you are the only faithful servant of God left? Do you ever feel that you are not being effective at what you are doing for the Lord?
All right.
Do you ever feel like the church is in a standstill? Well, I do.
Right.
Sometimes. Sometimes I get tired and discouraged. Sometimes I wonder what the purpose of it all is. Learn that not only being a pastor by trade, but also being a Christian by lifestyle can be very discouraged.
Wow, all right.
Reason is, most people don't care about the future of the church. As I look around, I know there are many that have been Christians for many years. And perhaps this morning you are weary. Perhaps you are discouraged. And if you are, I want to bring a message to you that applies to us all. So many times we as Christians go through spiritual highs and lows, and we're riding on a giant roller coaster of faith. Sometimes we get really excited and we want to charge hell and pull people out of the fight.
Right.
We want to fight hell with the water pistol. Sometimes we get really excited and want to consume every ounce of information that we can about God. This is the way that Peter was when Jesus said that he was going to be handed over and killed. And Peter spoke up and said, no way, I won't let you go. I will even come and die with you.
All right.
Other times we get down and discouraged and we don't feel like we can do anything. Sometimes we look around the church and it seems like little is being done. Sometimes we get discouraged and flat out tired of hearing. Sometimes we feel like we're in a small minority of people who even hear. And it drives us to complacency. Drives us to do nothing but sit and contemplate on how bad things have become instead of being productive.
Right.
The attitude cools our fire down. This is the attitude of Peter after Jesus was arrested as he denied him 3 times. He started out strong and then denies Jesus.
Alright, come on.
Sometimes I want to know, what is the point? Why are we here? Does the church really have a chance to actually reach people? I know that in the past the church has been effective and some churches today are booming, but are we beyond the point of no return? What is the point of serving God diligently? What's the point of being a small voice amongst a screaming crowd? Can we really make a difference in the world? I've heard discouragement and weariness among the faith. I know that many are discouraged, but others lack of commitment.
Well.
Know that some want to be doing more than they feel they are doing. I want to assure you this morning, there is a point in all of this. There's a reason to keep on. There's a reason to be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord.
Amen.
Satan wants more than anything to render you ineffective for God's service.
Right.
Discouragement will come. I know many things have come along that have discouraged believers over the years, but do not give up.
Amen.
Do not bow down.
Brilliant.
Many hard times have befallen church folk all over the world, but do not let that be an excuse for complacency. I know there are many that feel tired and discouraged, but do not let Satan get the best of you.
Amen.
Paul charges the church at Corinth, and I want to charge Greater New Hope this morning, today, from the words of Paul. Be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord.
Yeah. All right.
So that you know that your labor is not in vain.
Right.
In the Lord.
Amen.
First thing we see from this text is Paul says, don't dwell in the past.
Right.
Many of us like to dwell in the past, because we think the past things were so great.
Well, yes.
But we cannot sit back and reflect on past success and failures and expect to grow.
Amen.
I know there have been many good times in this church and many hard times, and those are in the past, and we cannot dwell on them. We cannot dwell on the what ifs because they are just hypothetical. The past simply drag you down. It's great to remember the past and reflect on things and learn from mistakes, but the truth is you cannot have the past back. It's gone. And we need to let it go. Y'all see some folks that have gotten a little older and they still, see if I can get it right, Brother Shepherd. They still 50 years old and they still want to bust the sand.
Well,
somebody knows what I'm talking about. Some of our older ladies, they used to dress a certain way when they were young and they think they still got it and still want to wear it. Somebody just gotta let the past go. Nail bottoms are out of style right now, so I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet. But one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead. I want to encourage you this morning.
Amen.
Whatever was done in the past, let it go and press forward.
Amen.
I know somebody hurt you in the past, but let it go.
Amen.
I know somebody did you wrong in the past, but let it go.
Amen.
It's in the past.
Amen.
And we need to move forward.
Amen.
We need to move forward.
Amen.
Don't dwell in the past. Now, secondly, we've seen that we need to be optimistic about the future.
All right.
We need to be optimistic about the future. Well, what is that word optimistic? That word means simply a feeling or belief that good things will happen in the future. A feeling or belief that what you hope for will happen.
Right.
An inclination to put the most favorable construction upon action and events, or to anticipate the best possible outcome.
Amen.
That's optimistic. But you know, there is the opposite of optimistic, which is pessimism. Y'all ever seen some folks that are like that? And they're the complete opposite. They have the inclination to emphasize adverse aspects, conditions, and possibilities, or to expect the worst possible outcome.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all seen them kind of folks.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
You say, it's nice outside.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it's going to rain tonight. I lost 10 pounds. Yeah, but you need to lose 20 more. The best that they can. was in vain. He had to be frustrated at the immorality of the Corinthians, the ignorance of the Galatians, and the abuse of God's grace of the Romans. He poured his life into those people only to have them not get the point. What is the point? I'm glad you asked. The point is we are called to be faithful, and that is all we can do. We must be faithful until the end. Let us do our part, no matter what. We need to be faithful until the end. We need to work our hardest right now. Quit trying to find excuses why you can't work, and just plug in and get the work done. It's kind of like every time I see things at the state, I always ask them, how many state employees does it take to change a light bulb? You'll see one guy up on the ladder, one guy down holding it, and two other guys standing around watching. How many people does it take to change one light bulb? We need to work our hardest. Not only do we need to work our hardest, we need to work smarter. We need to work hard. Right now. Don't dwell in the past. Be optimistic about the future. And then work your hardest in the present. And then fourthly, he said simply, stand firm.
Stand firm.
We need to stand firm. The believer is to stand firm, letting nothing move him. Why? Because he has such a glorious hope. The hope of being resurrected and given an imperishable and immortal body and an incorruptible life before God.
Amen.
The hope of this glorious fact should stir the believer to stand firm. Letting nothing move him in serving the Lord Jesus Christ. The word stand firm means to be steadfast. It means fixed and determined and purposed and faithful. The believer is to stand firm and fixed in his belief and labor for the Lord. Determined to live for the Lord and to carry out his purpose for the Lord. The believer is to be faithful until the end.
Amen.
The believer is to give himself fully to the work of the Lord. The work of the labor means toiling and working to the point of exhaustion and fatigue, to the point of collapse. And I just look around and think about some of the folks and young folks that I see nowadays that they don't know what hard work really is. They really don't understand what hard work is, but mean working to the point of exhaustion.
All right, yeah.
They have 10 minutes to talk about, can I get a 15-minute break? You ain't done no work yet. But that's how folks are. And we've got to work while it is day. Because night comes when no man can work. The word always means never cease, never stop, never slacken, never quit, never retire. We need to stand firm this morning. I believe if we would stand firm, the church would be a different place. I believe if we would stand firm this morning, we'd have more folks looking at me this morning. I believe if we stand firm, we'd have more folks on Wednesday night in Bible study.
Right,
I believe if we stand firm, we'd have more folks at Sunday school on Sunday morning. Be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Don't dwell in the past. Be optimistic about the future. Work your hardest in the present. Stand firm. And then finally, and then I'm going to let you know. He says, you will be rewarded.
All right.
I don't know about you, but I like rewards.
Yeah.
I like a little pat on the back every now and then.
Yeah.
It's encouraging. We have employee of the month at my job. And I try not to get upset when other folks get it. I've been there 17 years, led special programs and done all kinds of special assignments and got no recognition at all. And got a new secretary coming here late every day to work. And they give her a blue out of the month. And I'm thinking,